Yeah, you know, I'm playing a character who is a reporter from the 1930s, and there's a story that there's this mermaid whose water is apparently healing water, and if you drink her water, you become well. So my character follows the scent of the story and meets the mermaid, and he actually has a daughter himself who's ill, who has respiratory problems, lung problems, so he thinks maybe this might be able to help her, this liquid, this elixir. But he learns that there's actually a much darker side to this mermaid's life. And so he and his niece, they end up trying to free the mermaid. And it's sort of an adventure story, and it's for children. It obviously isn't on the budget size of the Disney adaptation that they're going to make. It was a small film, but it has a lot of heart. You know, for what it doesn't have in the budget, we made up for it in the heart and the emotion.
And this is coming from the big hit, Beauty and the Beast.
That's true. Beauty and the Beast has done so well, and I'm so happy for all of those people, because I know that, like the Narnia films, was a much-loved story and a much-loved book. You know, everybody knows Beauty and the Beast, especially from all the Disney, the Disney cartoons. So I'm so glad it's lived up to the hopes and dreams of all of the
Do you
viewers.
Somehow feel pressured? Because Little Mermaid is a classic we all love.
I don't feel pressured, actually. I just feel excited for people to see the film.
Because it's different. It
because
has a
it's
different
different.
twist.
And you know what? Maybe if we'd made almost a shot-for-shot remake of the cartoon, then I think, oh, I really hope this is going to connect with people, and I hope they get the emotion, and hope I live up to Eric. But this is totally different. And so I think people are going to see this story for what it is. And there it is, up on the screen.
There you go.
Yeah.
Where is your character there?
Hopefully it'll be, well, there's the baddie, as you can
Yeah,
see.
you know, you do look like Prince Eric, even if you're not playing his character. Okay, very
Yeah. Oh,
exciting.
I'm so happy you guys have the trailer, because it really was a labor of love, this film, and I'm very proud of it.
There, I think that was you.
That was
So
me.
when you see the characters that you've played over the years, Peter from Narnia, and
Yeah.
now Asai from Carrot Pilby, you're going to play this character in Little Mermaid.
Yeah.
How do you see your career growing? How has your character, your acting skills evolved over the years? Are you playing more serious roles now, or what do you think?
That's a very good question. And it's quite interesting. You know, I've been very lucky in a way that I've worked on a lot of scripts that I like and that I care about. You know, I started off in this beautiful franchise film. You know, it had a lot of magic and a lot of heart, and was about a family that I think a lot of people connected to, and had a great spirituality aspect to it, actually, no matter what religion you are from. And I think that sort of set me in motion to try to make films that connect with people on that emotional level. And I will continue to do that. I'll continue to make things that, you know, about a family or about love or about something that is emotional, because that is, as humans, what we connect to.